हेलो, वेलकम टू द डीबीएमएस लैब 3. सो इन दिस डीबीएमएस लैब 3 वी विल टॉक अबाउट क्वेरीज दैट विल बी द सिंपल क्वेरी फॉलोड बाय यूनियन इंटरसेक्शन क्वेरीज क्वेरीज रिलेटेड टू नेस्टेड सेट ऑपरेशन. So these will be the key items towards taking up. For all this exercise, we need to work on silo, reserves, and votes table. So we will be working especially on these three tables to look into any form of a basic query. So for that, what we will do is we will be using the live SQL and let us start by creating the table 1. We call it as silo. Next, the table 2, that is the votes. Table 3, we call it as reserves. Then we will insert 10 rows. Then we will insert 10 rows for the Sailor database. Then we will insert 4 rows into the boat database. Later, we will insert 10 rows in the reserves database. Then, to start up with basic SQL queries, now we need to understand what is going on here. That is, select all the tuples which are in silos. So we can hit on a run button. Now you can see all the 10 rows which are a part of the silos database are displayed here. Part of the Sailor database, they are displayed here. So we can take up all the 10 rows. So selecting the entire table here, thereby checking all the contents in the boards. So again, we are hitting on the run button and we will look that there are 4 rows which will be part of the second one, which will be part of the second query, and third is the table which is associated with the reserves database. So again, we have we are going to have 10 records which are associated a part of this table. So this is what we are as of now. So up to now we have just worked with the simple DDL and DML command. Now let us work with the simple command, where the questionnaire was find the names of names and ages of all the sailors. So here at this stage, now we will be using up distinct. Distinct is going to give up the unique values. That was the key takeaway what we have to look into this scenario. So distinct names, so names should be unique values. So if such is the case, we can put up this query here in our SQL editor. Then can understand. But before that, let us understand the data. What are the names which are distinct? So now, Dustin is occurrence is 1, Brutus is occurrence is 1, Luber occurrence is 1, Andy occurrence is 1, Rusty occurrence is 1, Horatio 1, Jorba 1, and again you can see this is Horatio. It is repeating for 2 times. Art occurrence and Bob occurrence is also 1. So now we are going to have 10 records. But as we are going to use distinct, unique, instead of 10 records, we will have only 9 records. The reason was, Horatio is repeating for 2 times. So that's the reason why we are interpreting this as an answer. Now go back to the SQL editor and see how this query is going to execute. So now you can understand here. There are 9 records at this case. There are only 9 records which are at this case. So Horatio occurrence is going to be made only for 1 time. So this is what the importance of distinct is going to mention up. So distinct, it picks up or it is going to give up the unique values in the table. So it is working with the unique values of the table. So that is how we should understand the distinct feature is going to be classified at this model. Okay. Now, let us see the second query. Let us now propagate towards the second query. So the second query, it was talking or it was telling, find the sailors whose rating is above 7. So we have to check up, that is, sailor rating is greater than 7. Okay. So now let us move to the database at this point. Now sailor rating is above 7. So 8, 8, 10, 9. There are 4 records, right? So 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 records. Sailor's rating is greater than 7. So the answer should be 4. Now for that, what is the query we need to give up first? You need to say all sailors. So I need sailor ID, sailor name, sailor rating, and sailor age. So these are what we call it as target list. From it is going to be called as class. Sailor, we mention it as the database. So sailor, yes, we call here as an instance, or we are going to call it as LSS. Okay. Where it is going to be called here as a condition clause. So we are interpreting with the clause condition, and this is greater than, we call it as a comparison operator. Greater than, we call it as a comparison operator. So let us check whether the four records as mentioned are occurring or not. So what we can do is, we will select up the query here, move to the working space we were actually on, and thereby we will hit the run button and see whether the interpreted answer by us, that is the four records, are occurring or not. So now you can see five records are there. So let us go back to the database. So one more thing we are going to have here was five, 10 is also going to be there. So we will be having five records. We will be having five records here. So 31, 32, 58, 71, and 74. So Luber, Andy, Rusty, Zorba, Horatio, with rating is greater than 7. So how did I get it? I am using the where clause condition, and then from what table I am going to pick. So instead of writing the complete name, I am going to use the aliases, and thereby I am going to use these variables a part of it. Now pick up the answer and store it in after the query. So it gives us a quick reference and also to understand what we are working on. So let us propagate with one more query. That is, the other query was find the names of sailors, find the names of a sailor who have reserved boat number 103. Find the name of the sailors who have reserved boat number 103. That means, at this case, we should now understand that we need to have two tables. The two tables what we need to bring up this relation was, we need to work with one sailor table, then we need to work out with the reserves table. So let us dump the two tables at a consecutive positions so that it will be quite easy for us to navigate the data. So for that, what we will do is, we will copy the image and let us bring this into our work area, so that it will be very easy for us to understand what should happen and the location where it is to be moved. There is something wrong here. So it is taking up a lot of space. So I ignore that. So instead, what I will do is, I'll one more try one again the application databases. This is the part. I can copy this image and bring it into this for this is just only to have a quick understanding and not to move here and there. Okay. Only for that we are looking into this aspect. So I can put this for the further queries also. It will be a good reference for each and every query. Second time, third time, forth. So then we will have question, database, query, and what was the proposed answer. So all in one, we will have at the same position. That will be very easy for us to interpret these things in, instead of scrolling the window here and there. So that is the only point that we are. So, yeah, this is the query as of now. Now, find what was the query. We will query was find the name of sailors who have reserved a boat at 103. Who have reserved the boat at 103. So this was the query. What we have to be looking it for execution. So if such is the case, name of sailor will be in sailor's database. Okay, who have reserved boat number, reserves comma boat information will be in reserves database. So we need to use multiple tables. So how we can backtrack this question was who has reserved boat number 103. So let us go back to the working set here. 103 103 103. So we do have three times the occurrences. 122, sailor ID 31, and sailor ID 74. So now we can move to the sailor database. Then we can identify the names which are associated in parallel to that content. So we were marking 22 name was Dustin. Then we were talking about 31 he was with Luber. 74 he was with Horatio. So 22, 31, and 74, and all of them, they are going to reserve the boat number 103. All the three members, they are reserving 103 as a boat number. Now, how can I get this? I am going to use select command, which we are going to use as a part of a data manipulation language. From and where, we call them as clauses here. Yes and R, we call them as database aliases here. Now we are making condition one. Another condition, we need to check boat number was 103. So boat number was 103. So where is this boat number? Boat number is in R. So therefore we call here as R.bid. Next one, where SID is equals to RID. That means he should belong to a sailor and thereby he should exist in the R. He should make a reservation. So at this case, we are going to interpret in this model. So let us now verify how the query has to be executed via the live SQL part. So now we are bringing up the same query and check whether the same answers are going to be prevailed at this model or not. So now you can see that Dustin, Luber, and Horatio. So these are the three tuples what we are expecting as an answer to this exercise, are expected as an answer to this exercise, right? So this is how we were talking about the simple query. So in this simple query, we mentioned was we are now working with the multiple tables. So that is the reason why we made this operation. Okay. Now, one more interesting part was find the Siler IDs. Find the Siler IDs who have reserved a red board. So we need only the Siler IDs. So at this case, we don't need this table because Siler IDs are available. So here we can use we can use only reserve and both. Since query part needs only SID, so obviously we don't need the Siler part as of now. Next, find the Siler who has reserved a red board. So where, what is the color of a red? So now we should understand color of a red. It is a variable in the board. Then the color of a red, one was 102 and one was 104. So now check where are these 102 and 104. So 102, 104. So the color was red here. Okay. So who has reserved a red board? So that is the reason why we are filling up this. And we are taking up the Siler IDs. So 22, who has reserved 102? Another occurrence of 102, that is Siler ID 31. Another occurrence of 102, that is 64.3. Then another board was 104. So who has taken 104? Again, 104 was picked up by Siler ID 22. So now we are expecting four tuples to be a part of our relation. So we are expecting four tuples, that is 22, 31, and 64. Okay. Now, what are the two conditions we have to take up? One, we have to say the board ID. Board color. Okay. So in board dot color is equals to some red. So this is condition number one. Okay. Then how is this met? So for that, what we can do up was we will be pulling up the query as follows. So what we mentioned was we were mentioning the board ID, what we are mentioning. This is condition number two. What is condition number one? Board ID must be in both reserve and board table. then only you can understand, right? So for that we are mentioning this as condition 1 and red is an condition number 2. So these are the two conditions what we are going to be prevailed with this answer. We are displaying only R dot SID. Then we mingle with two tables, vote and result, from clause, where clause we are going to use, and we call AND as a logical operator. So then we are going to use AND operator. So I have A and I have B. Then if I am going to say A and B, so if it is true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false values, then at this case, we need to mention A and true. So, and it is going to give up the multiplication. So it gives up false, false, false. So both should be true. So this is the case what we are going to say. Both condition must be true, then only the query is going to execute. Then only the query executes. Both the conditions must be true, then only the condition will be executed. So now let us see how a SQL is going to prompt up to this query. So let us look to the SQL editor here. Now we are working with the two clauses, from clause and where clause. I'm hitting the run button, so query is going to get executed. So we have 22, 22, 31, 31, and 64 as the answers. We have 22, 22, 31, 31, and 64. So 31 is given here, right? So 31 is also at the second type. So we have 5 tuples. We have the 5 tuples. So 31 also. So we have 22, 22, 31, 64, and 31. So these are the 5 answers what we are going to check it up. So this is how a AND part is going to be satisfied. Now let us move to one more query. So at this query, find the names of the filer who has reserved a red board. So names of the filer. So names of filer. So second thing, reserved red board. So we need table number 1, table number 2, table number 3, because names are available at this part. So names are available in silo, reserves at this, and red color in this model, right? We are going to have reserved at this point and red color at this point. Now how to start the query execution? Where to start the query execution? The thing was, who has reserved red board? First of all, check red board, that is Interlake and Marine. So 104 Marine is red color, 102 Interlake is red color. Now, just put some tick marks for further understanding who has reserved it. So, who has reserved 102? Occurrence 1, occurrence 2, occurrence 3. So, 102, it is going to have 3 occurrences. Now, let us see 104 occurrences. 104 occurrences is for first time. 104 occurrences is for second time. So 101 unchecked, 103 unchecked, 103 unchecked, 101 unchecked, 103 is also unchecked here. Next one, what we can do is we need to identify the filer names. But here we are going to have only filer IDs. Here we are going to have only the filer IDs. So as we are going to have the filer IDs, from the filer ID, we need to map out two filer names. So map out, that is Dustin. Next, again it is Dustin, no doubt about it, because we got the same thing. Next one, we have Luber with 31 here. Of course, again, Luber, he is bringing up the vote number 104. Next, we do have Furiakio, and he is choosing vote number 102 in the interlake vote. So now, as per the thing, what we should expect, the answer should be 22-31-64, named with Dustin, Luber, and Horatio. So using these, we should be following up the contents. But occurrences of 24, occurrences of 24 is for second time. Occurrences of Luber is for 20 times. So, 2 times. 31 is also for 2 times, and Andy, that is Furiato, is only for 1 time. Okay, that's how we check up. Now, how to build the query? Building the query is that for the color, we have to check up ports. For the reserves, we have to check up reserves table. And for the name of the sailor, we need to check up the sailor table. So we need to fit up with 3 conditions. Condition number 1, sailor and reserves. Condition number 2, reserves and boats. Condition number 3, with 3. So if all the 3 conditions are satisfied, then we get the answer. So let us see how the answer to be expected as of now. How will be the answer to be interpreted at this model? So, selecting of the query, moving it to the SQL editor, moving it to the SQL editor. So again, we are using the select command. We use from clause and where clause. Sailors, reserves, boats, all the 3 tables are brought up. The LSS, S, R, and B are taken up. Then we made a condition which should exist. The sailor ID should exist both in reserves and sailor table. Similarly, the vote ID should exist both in reserves table and vote table. And the color is, of course, it is part of the vote. So let us hit the run button to see and get the answer. So now you can see there are two instances for Dustin, two instances for Luber, and one instance for Pareto. So total number of records what we expected earlier were 5. How many records we expected earlier? So there are 5 records. So what is the 5 records? Two times Dustin should come. And two times Luber should come. And one time Horatio to come. So total we are expecting 5. So all the 5 were our part of the answer. Now, let us check one more simple query. Let us work on one more simple query. So this simple query was find the color of the board reserved by Luber. Now, name is equals to Luber. Then we need Seiler table. Next, he reserves a board. So we need reserves table. Next, we need to find the color of table in vote table. So we need votes table. Therefore, 3 tables are needed to build the SQL query. So let us start working with it. Luber is there. So 31, this is Luber. So what is Luber SID? Luber SID is equals to 31. Okay. Now, where is this 31 taken up? First instance, second instance, third instance. So 3 times 31 is there. Now, 31 is choosing 102. What is color of 102? It is red. 31 is choosing 103. Now what is color of 102? It is green. 31 was choosing boat number 104. So obviously we need to check up 104. So now we need color. The word was colors here. So 3 colors with vote ID 102, 103, 104 must be chosen. So this is the answer we need to get up. So for that, our interpretation was how we can build up the SQL query for this. Now find the color of a board. So color of a board we need to find. Therefore, we are now saying vote color. We need three tables, silo, reserves, and board. From clause, where clause, S select, it is used to retrieve the values. From and where are the clauses? Condition number one, condition number two, condition number three. So all three conditions must be met. So we use and here, we use and here. Now check whether the three colors, that is red, green, one more occurrence of red is arriving or not. For that, we are building the live SQL. So we said take up color, three things, and verifying whether the condition SID is available in both silos and reserve table. Verifying the condition whether the boat ID exists both in reserve table and boat table. And finally, we verify in the silo table whether the person called as Luber is a person, Luber exists in the table or not. So once this query is taken up, now we are hitting the run button. So now you can see the three colors what were displayed. One it is red, another it is green, another it is red. So these are the answer what we were expecting manually, what we expected manually here. So we were telling that it should be red, it should be green, and it should be red. So the same colors we are talking about, that is display. Now let us move to the next query. Let us move to the next query here. So the next query was find the names of a sailor who have reserved at least one boat. Who has reserved at least one boat. So we don't want all the instances. We don't want all the instances to be taken up, but the person should be in both the sailors and reserves. So as of now, we don't need this boat table, right? So why we don't need the boat table? Because why we don't need the boat table? Because we are already using up with this values, that is we are not talking about color or name. So at this case, what we can write is no need to use boat. The thing is, names of the sailors has to be printed and who has reserved at least one boat. So boat ID is available in reserves table. So we can use only two tables. We can use only two tables, sailors and reserves. So now let us start this. Name of the sailor who has reserved at least one boat. So in this case, what we can take up was, now SID 22 22 22 22 31 31 31 64 64 and 74. Total we are going to have 10 records. So names of sailors, so what are the names of sailors? 22, so it is taken up here, 22. Then we will be getting the word Dustin. Next, 31. So 31 is here, and the name of 31 was Luber. Then we had 64. So 64 name was Horatio. And another one was 74. So 74 name is also Horatio. So we will get 22, 22, 22, 22 for four times. Luber, we will get 31, 31, 31 for one time, three times. Horatio was 64, Horatio with 74. So total we should get 10 tuples. Total 10 tuples should be the answer. 10 tuples should be the answer. So how these answers are generated? So we will select the name from the Siler. Then we have to check whether there was a reservation for an appropriate boat or not. So we will be using SID and RID. So with this, we will find it out whether the names are going to be part of this 10 records or not. So we will select this command here. Select the command here, and then we will start working up here. So just verify how many records are there at this. So Dustin occurrences was four times, Uber occurrences was for three times, Horatio occurrences was for three times. So the reason was Dustin was taking up 102, 103, 104, and 31 Luber was taking up boat number 102, that is Interlake, 103 the Clipper boat, 104 the Marine boat, and 64 of course he takes the Interlake, but the color was blue. But another 74 Horatio, he is taking boat number 103, that is Clipper and Green. So that's how we are going to get the answer. Now, after this simple query, let us find out the query which are going to be worked with string functions. So the thing to work with the string function will be as follows. Now, find the ages of sailors whose name begins and ends with D, and they should have at least three characters. They should have at least three characters. The name should begin and end with B and has at least three characters. Now, name beginning B, name ending with B. So this doesn't fit. Dustin doesn't fit, Luber doesn't fit, Andy doesn't fit, Rusty, no. So starting should be B, ending also should be B. So for that, we will not take up the 9 record. Only the 10th record is going to fit. And his name will start with B and end with B. And there should be at least 3 characters. So what we can write is name starts with B and ends with B, and there are 3 characters in his name. So that's the reason why we will choose up the record here. Okay. Now, we need to find the ages of the sailor. So age of the sailor, this is rating. Another one was age. Name is boss. SID was 95. So the answer should be 63. So answer should be 63 for Bob. So this is what the answer we need to propagate with this age, because we have to pick up age. So age is only 63. Now, how can I put this orientation in string form? So we need to display s.age, sailor's age, and we need to work where the data has to be brought, that is sailor table. And like is a command which does comparison in string operations. So like is a command which it is going to do comparison here. So percentage and slash or hyphen, these are called as wild cards. These are called as wild cards, and of course they use in strings. They are going to use with strings. So B space here, then it is going to end up with B. B, it is going to start with B and end up with B. So that is what we were looking it up. So we can say the name is like. So S dot name like. This is wizard word. And then we are going to put B and space, and then we put percentage B, etc. So let us see how this query is going to execute. How this query is going to execute. So what we can do is we can select this query here. Now select this query here. Then we move to our live SQL. So you can see like, it is a string command here. String command here. Then we hit this and check the answer. So no data was found. So let us move with the small letter B here. So check whether the data was found. Now again, we can say that there is no data. And now you can see this age was 63. Age was 63. You can check the answer here. So now we are talking with case sensitivity. That is case sensitivity. So we should use a lowercase letter at this case to get up the answer. So age, it is choosing up as 63 to display the answer. Okay. Now, find the ages. The another query was, find the ages of sailors whose name begin with R. So we don't use reserves table, we don't use vote, we need only the sailor table. And we need to check the name of a sailor is starting with R character. So we should get Rusty. We should get Rusty from the table, because it is starting with an R character and the age was 35. So 35 should be the answer. So for that, what we can do is we can simply change the word like here. You can simply mention instead of being, now we are changing with like. So hit on this button and check his age. It should be 35. So we will be getting 35 as of now. 35. So this is all from the simple query. So in simple query, we were talking about the complete functionality. Then we talked about comparison operators and mingling with operations with single table and mingling with operations with multiple tables, etc. So this is all from working with the simple table. So we will go to the main and stop the recording here.